Do you need to create a questionnaire? Well, let me show you how Jotform is your no-code solution to creating just that. Hey Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly, and as you can see, I'm currently in the desktop version of my workspace. And like I mentioned, if you're wanting to create a questionnaire, you can absolutely do that with Jotform. It is user-friendly and no coding knowledge needed. So for this, I'm gonna go to the top left-hand corner. Let's go ahead and create. And from this, we're going to choose form. Now there are some options here. We can use the AI option at the top. So if you want to give it an example of the type of questionnaire you're looking for, it could potentially create a really great questionnaire for you. Down here at the bottom, we can start from scratch. So if we know exactly what we're looking for, we can do that, but we can also utilize a template. So if I choose templates, I can search up at the top, but over on the left-hand side, if I come down, we see right here, we have questionnaire templates. And we can take a scroll through here so that way we can get a good idea of how other questionnaires are laid out and the questions that they're asking. But for this example, I'm gonna go ahead and head back. Let's start from scratch and I'm gonna use the classic form. Now, one of the great things about this being no code is everything is drag and drop. So on the left-hand side, we can choose to add an element. And honestly, you don't even have to drag and drop. We can just click. So I'm just gonna click on full name, email, let's do phone number. And then from here, we can add in some extras to get information from our user. So let's go ahead and do a couple of short text. We can do a drop down. We have, let's go ahead and do a multiple choice. And we can do a star rating. All right, let's go ahead, head back up here and let's edit some of these questions. I'm gonna do, what's your favorite candy? And what's your favorite store? And then let's do, what is your Enneagram? And then we can edit those options. I'm just gonna do a few just for the sake of this example. And then let's do preferred work schedule. And we can do morning, afternoon, evening, and then we'll do overnight. And then over on the right-hand side, you can see every time we click on one of these, the panel opens up on the right-hand side to edit the properties. So if we want to change something over here, we can definitely do that. So for this multiple choice one, we have some options. We can choose predefined options as well. And we can also choose another option. And of course we have surveying, which is entry limits. We can shuffle the options as well. But let's finish up with this last question. How was this questionnaire? All right, let's go ahead and change the name of this to Team Questionnaire. And once we click out, it should change the title right up there. We can also choose the form designer over here on the right, and we can change the overall look and feel of the form. So if we have a specific brand, we can absolutely change that to match that. Or if we have specific colors, or if we want to add in an image, we can do that here. We also have different styles. So if we want to change the font, maybe an overall theme is what you're looking for, or if you decide that you prefer to go to the card format instead of the classic, we can do that here. Now, if we come up to settings over on the left-hand side, we have some more things that we can do. One of the things is gonna be conditional logic. So if you want to show hide a field, you can customize your form based on your user to increase their participation and make their overall experience better. So just for example, let's say if someone said that their Enneagram was a 3, maybe we don't want to show them the work schedule, or maybe we don't want to ask them how this questionnaire was. We can show hide based on specific responses. Back up under settings, we can also change that thank you page. We can have the general thank you page, or we can redirect to an external URL. And of course, we also have some integration. So if you're going to have them upload something, maybe a document or a picture, you can easily integrate with third party. You can have that go to Google Drive, Box, Dropbox. But let's take a look at the publish tab. From here, we can easily copy this link to send through the appropriate channels, or we can invite by email. If we scroll down, we have a QR code as well as social media examples to share on. So let's go ahead, top right hand corner, I'm going to choose to preview the form. And one of the things that I like about this is that it is mobile responsive. So depending on if you're a phone, tablet, or desktop, it's going to fit the screen perfectly. All right, I'm going to jump back over to desktop. Let's go ahead and do a quick fill form. Perfect. Let's go ahead and give some specific examples. We'll do Snickers and Perfect, we'll go ahead and submit. We have to give the questionnaire a 5-star, right? Let's go ahead and jump out. We can easily see the data by jumping over to tables. All right, and here is where you can see all your data. Now, once you have more responses, you can also come to most of these and you can click on the 3 dots and you can summarize with a chart so you can visualize all of your data. Now, a couple of things to keep in mind is this is HIPAA friendly and we are GDPR ready. Now, since we are back on the dashboard of our workspace, we can easily come to more and view our form analytics for more in-depth information. And it's as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to create your own questionnaire with Jotform, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.